Welcome, Earthlings, to an episode of Draw with Gabriel, I guess. So, I'm going to be showing you how to draw a baby dinosaur nuzzled somewhere in some rocks and some grass. Tools, pencil. Well, this one's for the outline. This is for detail. This is for the outline. I want to be using the chisel. Eraser. And a pencil sharpener. So let's start with the basics. Begin with the gestures. Draw a contour line for the background and the neck of the baby dinosaur. Then draw mesh shapes for the head of the baby and the eggs. Remember to use very light pencil strokes. Okay. Gonna be an egg. And place the other one here. Is going to be the baby dinosaur. This is going to be his head. This is his body right here. This line is going to be a little higher. Last line is going to be right there. Use your gesture to sketch the outline of the nest, rocks, and face of the baby. Make sure to follow the contour line and mesh shapes during this step. Keep your sketch loose and undetailed. Your goal is to create the nest scene, outline, and general shape. Gonna have some grass here. It's a rock. Grass. Like so. Give these eggs a bit more shape. Begin to fill the details of your scene. Focus on the outlining the rocks, eggs, and grass. Start adding details of the facial features. Okay, so I'm gonna move on now to a liner. I believe this is a 0.5 lead, which is quite thin, the thinnest I've seen around. I don't know if any professional pencils have any thinner than 0.5. Because one of my markers is 0.5, and that's like really thin. It's not needle-like, but close enough. Okay, so we're gonna do some detailing. It's time to finish the line drawing, go over the biggest areas of the egg, and face off the baby before adding the... I'm going to read that over again. It's time to finish the line drawing. Go over the biggest area of the egg and face of the baby before adding the details, then draw the baby's eyes, nostrils, and mouth. Time for the line work. It doesn't look right. actually going to need a fine point for this one. So that was a 005, and then this one is the, what's the difference? So now the reference picture. Well, I'll show that one at the end. Final step is to add the value to your line drawing. Begin by sketching a small circle for your light source. Refer to it as your shade, as you shade your scene. Start from the lightest highlight and build to the darkest shadows. Adding midtones is in between. Pay attention to what is in the foreground, midground, and background. All dinosaurs hatch from eggs. When they emerge, cracks and breaks appear where the most pressure is being applied from the inside of the shell. Let's use this little Batman as my light source. He's going to be my light source. That's where the light is going to be coming from. Okay. Now I'm going to use this eraser to get rid of all of the pencil marks. Pretty sure it's gonna look better once it's colored in. Everything does. Now the reason I erase the pencils, the pencil is so it won't smudge when I color. Using Mars plastic eraser. I like the little handle. And the case. So it won't get dirty. I use a brush. Because sometimes the marker does smudge even though when I go over it with the hand. Some markers do, some don't. Green. A tortilla, a tortillion is just rolled up paper. These came in some art supplies that I have bought before. These are used just for blending. It's not blending too well. And the tortillons, you can sharpen them with sandpaper. And that's what I think it is. It looks like sandpaper. Okay, what else? It's not really blending. He did a better job over here. Blending. Give it that smooth look to it and feel. This is probably one of my favorite tools to use as an artist. What color should I paint the dinosaur? Put an orange? I think we'll go purple. And light violet lavender. Well, we have more red to choose from. I think I'm gonna go with the pink. me color these eggs first. With the yellow orchard and some yellow. This is medium brown. I'm still trying to master my shading, so I'm gonna go ahead and just practice. I'm barely putting any pressure, just very lightly, because I want it to blend to give it that shade look. I want to make this egg look real. Give this a try. It was really messy though. doesn't look very real to me. I'm gonna add a really thin layer of this yellow orchard to see if I could blend it more into the background. It gets more difficult to add a color pencil once the teeth on the paper start to ease up. The paper becomes really slippery. It barely looks like I'm applying any kind of color. It's starting to look kind of red. Fine, let's see. Any difference? I'm gonna show you guys. I'm gonna show you earthlings how to sharpen a put the camera here because it gets dirty. So I guess they really didn't need that much sharpening. Okay, well, here. I'm gonna show what I'm talking about. It's a little shiny there. That's because the paper has no more tooth. Okay. Ooh. Doesn't look half bad. Okay, moving on. I'm gonna finish with a dinosaur. You know, I might as well finish all three eggs and I'll do the dinosaur last. I wouldn't suggest smudging with the fingers because of the grease that we produce. It's gonna leave your paper oily. So no finger blending. This set of color pencils, Tortillians, pencils, HB, B, 2H, 4B, 6B, and it also came with some pastels. It came with two Tortillians, this one and then a smaller one. This one came with an eraser and it came with a kneadable eraser. The kneadable eraser is a really fun tool. Because you can mold it into whatever shape you're trying to erase. Like you could actually mold it into really super thin, almost needle-like, in case you want to get into those details. Okay. Not bad. This one actually... this ink came out awfully good. Thank you. Yeah. And that's pretty much it. Yep. Okay. Till next time.